Good afternoon, all of you. So, today's session is all about financial instruments, part of your unit 1, financial environment. We have seen what exactly you need a financial environment in any country, and we followed with the discussions on the financial system structure, followed by objectives of financial system, nature of financial system, need for a financial system in a country like India or Pakistan or USA or Canada or Singapore, and what are the specific functions of a financial system, and who are the participants in that, and followed by important components or composition of a financial system, that is financial instruments, institutions, intermediaries, financial services, and regulators. All put together in our financial system, good or bad or any kind. So, let us start with the first component of the financial system, that is financial instrument. Monetary instruments, financial instruments, there is a little difference, but all put together we can call them as financial. An instrument, a physical instrument. Do you have some instruments with you right now? What is that? I'm not talking financial. In general. Do you have any instruments with you?
Yes.
What is that?
Coins.
Sorry?
Coins.
You have a pen. Someone else has a notebook or notepad. Are they instruments?
Yes, sir.
Why? They leverage your work. How do the instrument that you are carrying? And if some of you may put that in Google account or notepad or notepad, or some of you use the physical notes and pen. What is that you are trying to do? You are trying to write something what you understood here, what you wanted here. That's your advice. So it is enhancing your abilities for comprehensive learning. That's a physical tool. Similarly, you have financial tools which are required for transactions, investments, borrowing, lending, consumption in a financial system. A financial instrument is a kind of agreement or it's a component between two parties, could be an individual, a company, a government, anyone. Between two parties, for one it is an asset, for the other one it is a liability. For one, it is optional, for other one, it is mandatory. It goes that way. So, a financial instrument is obviously of financial nature, which means monetary transactions are there under this instrument's scope. Now, nature of financial instrument, if you ask me, obviously it is of financial nature, it has some term, it has liabilities. It has ownership and so on. An interesting part of financial instruments is, let us look at types of financial instruments. Okay? You have monetary instruments, you have investment instruments, and you have non-investment instruments. Okay? Some of you may ask me, sir, I think a monetary instrument is not part of financial instrument, as I already told you. It's completely different. The idea of putting monetary instrument is they are interchangeably used. The term changes. Money is used by everyone. For an economist, it is capital. For a company, it is fund or financing. The name changes. But at the end, it's all about money that we require. Okay? Maybe the size of money is demanded or supplied to which. So that's the reason not to miss that. I put everything in here. You put three different baskets: monetary instruments, investment instruments, non-investment instruments. Is it clear? The monetary instruments, I put cash equivalents, and plastic money or e-money. is cash? How do you define money?
Most liquid form of money is
cash. It's cash, that's what you call as liquid. Yeah? So it's a physical form. Anyone will accept. Okay? The money which we are using right now, what do you call that as? What type of money is it? Sorry? E-money? I have some 100 rupees and 100 rupees in my pocket. Sorry? Paper currency. Okay? Even coins. Metal coins, paper currency, which are printed and printed. My question again remains the same. What do you call this money as? And this? Yeah. Sorry? That's what you are saying, and someone is saying that. You are saying that there is no point of transferring it. You give it, it retains the value. You gave it, it gets the value. That itself has the value. Okay, I will put the other way. I have 5 rupees, let me say what currency would I have? No, I have some money, yeah, I have. This 100 rupees note is there in my hands. You all know about it, right? Both the sex, you're not believing me. It's not a fake note, it's a real note. Okay? You believe me? Now, you said paper currency. Someone said, you said that? Yeah. This is what you're talking about, right? I don't have a coin. Can anyone of you give me a coin? Quickly. Yeah. What is value? So we have 100 rupees note here, 2 rupees coin here. So what, is there any difference between these two? Can we call both of these as money? Can we? There is no doubt about it. But this is a coin, this is a paper currency. Paper currency. Okay? We all see this? Now, this is 2 rupees. Who is saying this? This is 100 rupees. Who is saying this? If your faculty says, will you accept this as 100 rupees? Who is saying this?
RBI.
So the government is saying, which government? Government of India is saying, yeah, we have to say this is 100 rupees. Okay? 100 rupees. So we are believing. Two RBA governor sign here. Okay? So what do you mean by this? Any idea what exactly? What is written here?
I promise to pay the bearer the sum of 100 rupees.
So who's promising?
RBA.
Yes. So what do you mean by that?
The possible of
value. He said, put it up value. He said that he said to promise me the value something. Like a promise in law, we say that I promise to pay the bearer 100 rupees. What do you mean by that?
Whoever issued it, he has to pay to whomsoever owes it or bears it. I promise to pay the bearer.
Same is the case with this also. Did you get it? All of you? Now, this 100 rupees itself has a value? Sure.
Artificially created.
Artificially authenticated. Signed by RBI. That we discussed already. If that is not there, still you believe it has a value? Say for example, now, this paper has value?
Yes, sir.
Has it value?
Yes, sir.
If I tear it? No, they will say it. If I tear it, they will say it. Yes. Right? So, if I tear it, does this have, does this 1 rupee note has any value?
Yes,
sir. Say something.
Yes, sir. Sir.
If I tear it?
Yes, sir.
If you tear it, you lose the value. You don't accept it.
This is
this those days are gone. Even if this kind of note is not taken, I'm at risk. Yeah, that is right. People don't accept this. In the olden days, yeah, it was, but now new regulations say, I will not. What I'm trying to tell you is, this money or that money, call it as fiat money. Fiat money. What do you mean by fiat money? It is a money which is designed, form of money in the paper form or some other form, which is not real. Inherently, this a piece of paper doesn't have any value. Okay? If you tear it, there is no value. Maybe that coin may have some value, but this paper doesn't have any value. Got it? So, that's how we call this as fiat money. A question for you. Can you tell me the oldest form of money?
Old.
Gold. Bronze. Silver piece.
Iron.
Iron.
Silver.
Bronze. Aluminium. Copper. So metals. Then anything else? Sorry? Water system. That's a good thing. In barter system, do you have money?
No,
not at all. You don't have money in barter system. Exchange of goods happen. It's not, there's no medium of exchange. How do you define money? Money is a medium of exchange. In barter system, you give me a bag of wheat, I will give you a bag of rice. That's a barter system. But the problem is, I don't have rice, but I want wheat. People accept something which is in common. It is accepted by everyone as medium of exchange, which we call as money. So my question remains, oldest form of money, most of you said metal. Is there any other? Yeah, money. Oldest form of money, most of you said, yeah, metal is over, this is stone, very precious stone. Tablet, maybe stone. Tablet is made of stone. Anything else? Shells, correct? Shells. Even shells are treated as medium of exchange. Anything else? Master. Okay, I tell you. Commodities. Commodities was also a form of money. In some set of villages, rice was accepted as money. Somewhere jute, somewhere wheat, somewhere maize. Whatever, commodities, agricultural commodities. Even before that, livestock. Camels, donkeys, goats, cow. In India, people worship cow. Even today, there's no religion here. Please note that. Misunderstand. There is no religion at all. There is no religious, it's not a religious belief. The oldest form of money in India, which was popular and ran as money for several centuries, was livestock in the form of cow. Whoever had maximum cows in the backyard is the richest person. That's all respect. We respect money, no? No, I gestured the 100 rupee note was not gold. Many of us respect money. In the same way, the olden days, cow was the money, form of money, which is livestock. And later on, people shifted the commodities, metals, but the respect retained. They got habituated. Not only that, there are many uses of them. We got habituated to how to get the derivatives of cow, important with milk. So we all created the culture. That's how it is. So, medium of exchange which is widely accepted in a country or place or region, you call it as money. Oldest form is livestock, followed by commodities, metals, and precious stones. Even before money, there was barter system as money. That is a snapshot about money. Right now, we have fiat money which we discussed. Right? And you remember, that's how I showed you 100 rupees. I promise a bearer to pay. By chance, does anyone want to have a dollar with you?
check if this kind of promise is written there. US dollar. Check.
There will be no promise written.
Is it written?
There's no promise. It's just a piece of paper. Look at the beauty of American economic system and their strategies. They have supplied their currency across the world. If American economy defaults, okay? I think, I don't know how many billions that will be lost. Because if there's a problem with rupee, you can go to Indian government and ask that equivalent value is important to go. But if the dollar, there's no promise. And they will be values. Anyhow, you have that? Anything written? Yeah. Most of the currencies they do that, Americans, they don't do it because nobody asks them. Why did you call them? Why did you bring the problems? Okay. Then later, I think Chinese were the first to use a checks and graphs kind of system where you need not carry physical currency, physical money. You can also use cash equivalents or money equivalents. Check and graph. Then now you have plastic money, credit card, and debit card. So those are the monetary instruments where no one can escape. We all are aware of them. But these two, which are financial instruments, we may not. If we are, there are various instruments of business. Okay? Let us see one by one. I differentiated these financial instruments into investment, non-investment. Okay? Maybe capital, non-capital, and up. You can take that way also. Fine. Which one should we see first? Okay, you go with this. Industrial instruments?
Sir,
yeah. I again classified them as tradable instruments, non-tradable instruments. Okay. I think in one of the classes I was telling you, form of SEBI. What is it? Anyone of you, what is SEBI? Yeah. Louder, please. Perfect. Securities Exchange Board of India. Good. What do you mean the securities there? Anyone?
They are tradable.
That's what I did here. If there is a tradable financial instrument, we call them as securities. As simple as that. Because they are transferable, you have a market for them, they are actually traded. Okay? First requirement is transferability. If transferability is there, you can market them. You can trade in them. So, when I say tradable financial instruments or investment instruments, I am talking about securities. That security is different, Abhishek. Securities which we have to put as collateral in the bank and take a loan as well. We talk about financial securities. Right? So you have debt instruments, equity instruments, hybrid instruments, and mutual funds. Okay? So, debt instruments, we already told you, debentures and bonds. Bonds and debentures are financial securities which can be traded, which can be transferred on even other state by our administrator, whatever the law is. Now, when you talk about any security or any financial instrument, you should look at liquidity. You should look at liquidity because you never know when you will be in the requirement of. So when you look at the liquidity, then I can say liquidity from issuer. Whoever issues the financial instrument. If you want money, you go to the issuer, he will give you. Okay? The other way, you
to be transferable. If you want a liquidity, which is not from the issuer, first thing is it should be transferable. Then you can claim your money. In addition to this, you may have some market for this or this financial instrument. If it is transferable, we can find a market. What do you mean by market? Common ruling of buyers and sellers for the same financial instrument. The third is tradable. Tradable means active or aggressive buying and selling of this instrument. We call it as tradable. Right? So, any financial instrument, as you said, you are saying, investors, buyers, you are saying, if I buy the financial instrument, the first and foremost thing I look at is liquidity. Liquidity means if a company is issuing the bond or debenture, who is an issuer. If you have bond money, company is giving, then we have to talk about this. I want the issuer. No, company clearly said, here, these are 10 year renewal bonds. Here, 10 years, I will, you cannot ask a single rupee. Then, can you go to an issuer? No. That's the reason the issuer give you a feature of transferability. I will not give you any money, but if you want to give to others, please go. Okay? Then, transferability makes market and trading active. Did you get that? All of you. So, my question again goes like this: why people go for markets is the issuer is not giving. There is a fixed period. Before that period, the issuer will not give a signal. Okay? Is it clear? Am I good? Am I good with a okay kind of place? Understandable? You all of you? I'm audible to you?
Sir.
Can you hear me? Coming back to debt instruments, bonds and debentures. They are securities. They are traded in the market, just now I explained. Why they are getting traded in the market? Okay. Because of this transferability, there is a market, BSE or NSE. If these companies' debentures have to be traded, means they have to be listed. For that, companies have to pay some money, which is called as an annual fee, to the exchanges, BSE, NSE, or any other regional exchange, like Hyderabad Stock Exchange or Kolkata Stock, like Capital Stock Exchange. Okay, then when you talk about debt instruments, there are different types. Bonds and debentures, precisely we cannot say there is a difference, but many scenarios there is a difference. Bonds are issued by companies which are issuing the bonds to the collateral, the secured, and debentures are related in some companies where they are reputed for their performance. They are top 10 capitalization companies in the country. And then no one says no for this kind of company's bonds. Images are issued by that kind of companies. Highly rated. There are bonds issued by governments. There are governments have issued images. Check. Debt instruments issued by government will never call them as debentures, you will call them as bonds. Bonds issued by Government of India. Bonds issued by corporations. Bonds issued by state governments. Andhra Pradesh state government issued ABCRDA Amaravati bonds in 2018. There was bonds. Okay? Sometimes, I think someone was asking me or telling me, convertible bonds, convertible debentures. Sometimes, companies offer you convertible bonds or debentures. Why do they do that or what happens there? That is, in convertibility, any instrument which is using convertible means it will be converted into shares. You can say convertible bonds means it will
converted into
shares
at a mature period of time.
Means till the maturity, we have to retain the bonds. At the time of maturity, the company will not give you the principal amount or the face value, but they will give you face value equivalent shares on your name. And this is told to you not at the time of maturity. At the time of investment, it is intimated. If you wish to, if you like to, you can. That is called as convertible bonds or convertible debentures. Then there is something called, there are some instruments called partially convertible bonds, partially convertible debentures. What do you mean by that? 100 rupees is the face value of a bond, and of course they will be converted into shares at the time of maturity. But the whole of face value will not be converted. Part of the face value of the bond will be converted. Say, face value is 100 rupees. At the time of maturity, as I said, 50% of 100 rupees is 50 rupees. Or 40 rupees, 75 rupees will be converted into shares. Rest of the face value will be given to the bondholder or debenture holder as cash. That's what you call as partially convertible. Partially convertible bonds or debentures and fully convertible bonds or debentures. Non-convertible bonds or debentures. Non-convertible means no shares. You get only your principal amount. Yeah. There is something called callable bonds, putable bonds. Have you heard about this? Anyone? So, you can hear? What are they?
Let's say,
what are
they? In a day, you can actually calling, I've heard that calling is selling.
Maybe you have heard the banking is there. It's not that. Anyone else? Callable bonds, putable bonds, Oh, you are getting into derivatives. Money market, derivatives. That's okay. That's okay. I am taking your guesses. Yeah. Okay.
Sir, is it about redemption?
Exactly. Redemption of?
Callable.
Redemption of?
Debentures.
That's it. It's all about the redemption of debentures. You're saying you will call. You will call the investors.
Right?
The terms are used callable,
putable.
No. Stick to the old one. Callable bonds, putable bonds. We are using these words, right? Callable bonds, as you rightly meant, I don't know how you said that. Callable bonds is an option given to the issuer. They will call the investors to sell their debt. They will call the investors. Actually, 10 years, 10 years. As you said, redemption. Before 10 years, the company is ready to redeem the bonds. And it is told you before investment, not later. So it is a right to the issuer, not to the investor. All of the bonds means it's all about redemption. But here, before the tenure, the investors or buyers of the bonds and debentures will ask for redemption. If buyers are saying that, we call them as putable. If sellers are saying that, we call them as callable. Callable bonds, putable bonds. Based on the right given. For example, I think you know what is happening with the financial institutions or NBFCs. Okay. Now, credit crunch is there. In this scenario, is it easy to get money or is it tough to get money? Do you agree with that? It says it is tough to get money. Now you tell me, in this scenario, you will try to look at callable bonds or putable bonds. Obviously, putable. It's an added feature fee. I'm issuing bonds to you all with the option that if you're not interested in this bond, you can ask me to give the money before the tenure, so that it attracts the crowd. You feel safe. Oh, I'm not locked. Then you can ask him why this kind of feature should be given. Because it's all about liquidity, right? It is all about liquidity. Then, a bond, liquidity is with the issuer. A typical bond, liquidity is with the issuer. Obviously, no. Then, he or she has to go to the market. Then I can say, you can ask me, sir, the all bonds are marketable and tradable. Why again this putable option? Or put option should be. Okay? My dear friends, please understand, listing a bond of a company or listing a debenture of a company does not mean that liquidity is assured. You are ready to sell, but there should be buyers. You are ready to buy, there should be sellers. Go to NSA basis portal. Because of that, I give you an option. And my company is response to you, I give an option called put option. Tenure is actually 10 years, but you can ask money before 10 years. It means the issuer is giving the liquidity. Yeah, I think you asked me that.
What if there is a put option? What if the next day I want to take that?
It's not next day or the same day, it's not like that. There is a process for that.
There is a company like that.
It's not there, maybe I will change the question. For example, I issued today and you invested today. The very next day, you are asking for money. That's not a good job. It is a complete misser. And you rightly ask that. So, it may not happen for days. I issued today, you invested today. After 1 month, you started asking me. It will definitely happen. So, what they do is, there are varieties of options within them. Company can give that option from any day, first day to 10th year, last day of the 10th year. Or they may say, no, first year, no option. Later onwards, anyway.
That is the login period. That is like login.
No, it is required as put option. But usually it's a matter of common sense because I want to pay your interest. If someone is saying, give me the put option from the next day onwards, I think you are not interested. You are not trusting me. Are you getting my point? So that creates some other kind of a picture for the company in the investors class.
So seeing it from a trader's point of view,
okay.
If I am having debentures, then it is not yet good. Can I expect, if the market is doing good, can I expect price rise?
That is something different. I'm sorry, I will answer this separately. That's part of the bond valuation. The price and valuation. Maybe this interest is sir, a plain bond without a putable option. Plain bond, this is option. Okay? And there is one more bond, same face value, same tenure, same coupon rate. But it has putable option. Is there any price difference? Maybe that could be a question. Right? Obviously, there will be a more demand for that bond compared to this. If both of them are the same kind of companies, valuation is a little different. That is the problem. Is it fine? Are you taking? Is it digestible? Huh? Or is it a hard food? Is it junk? You like junk food? Okay. So when you talk about debentures, the saga goes on like this. Bonds, debentures, convertible, non-convertible, redeemable, irredeemable. Irredeemable means there is no maturity at all. It's very difficult. Go on to the private industry, but you have a long tenure bond. Bonds issued for 100 years, 200 years, that kind of bonds are also there. Not in India, in US.
Even before the issue, will they tell that after 1 year?
Everything year. Before the issue. Whatever you are talking about is before the issue. Because after, what will be my mindset? If your bond issue is oversubscribed, I am so happy I will write on you guys. There are more discussions on this in the capital markets.
So let us talk more about co-instruments in instruments perspective. Is it clear? All of you get instruments? Related to get instrument, any question? Clear? Pure? Read this entry.
You have gone to the slides also, right?
Get instruments, read this entry. Can I go to the next one? Sure. Can I go to the next one, please?
Yes, sir.
Next is equity instrument relevant. I ask you always talk about equity. Okay? What is that?
Yes.
Yes. It's a financial instrument which gives the ownership, which means the profit belongs to you. If you are the equity shareholder, you have the ownership. And the ownership depends on the extent of the size of the ownership. More are the shares you are holding, more are the profits that you can take from them. 100% of the shares are with you, yeah, it's yours. Need not be 100%. Even more than 50% will give you. There are some people who are the founders of a company and they don't have a single share, still they dominate. Steve Jobs did that, but he did not. Infosys, Narayan Murthy is completely out, but still he is into the effects of that. You know what happened to the CEO's compensation issues last year? Okay? So, equity ownership gives you this kind of command. What's the difference between if I buy a share and a bond, which we discussed just now?
Guaranteed returns.
Guaranteed? Which one? Share? No, no, not guaranteed, not fixed. Maybe I wish you could tell you that. One of you asked me. On bonds and debentures, you may have different varieties of interest or returns paid. Coupon rate. It's also known as coupon rate, the rate of interest paid on the bonds that you get. We call them as coupon rate. Rate of interest is known to you. Have you heard about discounted bond and deep discounted bonds? None of you asked me, now I got it. Did you hear about them? Yes. What are they?
I have heard it like banks are involved in giving issuing discounted bonds where it is like every person that changes this one. The price value of the bond coupon rate comes down.
Okay, actually you are mixing two things here. One is, when we are talking about coupon rate or rate of interest, which would be fixed and flexible. Flexible called as floating, where interest rate keeps on changing according to the market interest. The bond was issued for 10 years, it could be fixed for all the 10 years, or it could be changing every year based on the market interest rates or benchmark interest rates. That's what you're trying to say. Anyone else? Discounted bonds? No. Discounted bonds means they don't pay coupon rate. They don't pay. They don't pay coupon rate every year. You will get whatever the interest rate at the end of the tenure. Means it gets accumulated. As simple as that. So, 100 rupees is the face value. They will give you something discounted to the face value, which is equivalent to the interest accrued for the tenure. That's what we call it as discount.
Zero coupon bond.
Yeah, even zero coupon bond also means the same. Zero coupon bond, discounted bond. You have to see. Then there is something called deep discounted bonds. Means the difference between the maturity value and face value. Actually, discounted bonds, maturity value and face value are the same. They will give the face value on the maturity. Okay? But the difference is how much you are investing now. That's important. Say, 100 rupees bond is issued for 5 years. Taking 8% as the current market interest rates, you
will be around 70 rupees plus, or it will around 70. Your investment today will be 70, it will become 100, because every year interest you get that gets compounded and accumulates, and you get full value of 100. 100 is discounted as 70 rupees, which we are calling as discounted. As you are asking me zero coupon bond, you invest 100 rupees here and you don't get any coupon rate. Coupon you don't get, there is a coupon rate actually. And at the end of the maturity period, say some 30 rupees plus got accumulated, then you get 130 rupees plus on maturity. Zero coupon bond. Then there is something called deep discounted bond. Means there is a huge difference between the investor value today and maturity. 100 rupees and 70 rupees, that's okay. I in the 90s, I invested in a bond called Sardar Sarovar Nigam Limited Bonds to fund the India's biggest dam. They issued for Gujarat government, issued that. Okay? So the face value was 1 lakh rupees. Face value is 1 lakh. Investment value is 3,500. So the difference. You believe it? It happened. The reason is the tenure is too long, 20 years. So you are paying 3,500 and after 20 years I get 1 lakh. So longer the tenure, more is the difference. Obviously. Okay? Did you get all of you? So zero coupon bond, discounted bond, discounted bond, callable bonds, putable bonds. Convertible, non-convertible, even secured, unsecured bonds. Unsecured bonds are very risky. You should not trust them. They have, but they have high returns. The market rate is 8%, they are offering 10-12% also. Because they are unsecured, very risky. Clear? Coming back to equity share, we are trying to compare equity share with the bonds and debentures. Debt instruments, coupon rate is fixed. Even if you consider floating of principal exchange rate, sorry, interest rate, that is okay. But in the case of equity shares, nothing is assured. You may get zero return every year also. That is also possible. And you get the maximum returns. That is also possible. And you get the ownership here, you don't get the ownership. Then the equity you have common shares and preferential shares. Common shares are the shares which we are talking about. Preferential shares are the shares which are issued for preferred people with the fixed commitment of dividend payment. Irrespective of company's progress, dividend payment. There are several reasons for that. And there are also different varieties. Redeemable preferential shares, irredeemable preferential shares, with lock-in period, without lock-in period, with voting rights, without voting rights, lots of varieties. Yeah.
So, in the market, any share price can fall below the face value. Does that mean that
we are talking about equity share or
equity bond? Can we mean that companies actually.
That is valuation discussion. That's not a good time to stop. That is a different market. As an instrument, let us see. That has been discussed. Equity valuation, bond valuation, valuation, debt security, that's been subject. We have something called security and preferable. And both deals in that. Personally, I can address you, but not very much. Then, hybrid, I think we already discussed. Convertible bonds. Convertible into what? Hurry. Into equity shares, convertible preferential shares, convertible into common shares. So, wherever you are using the word, convertible, it's about convertible into common share, common equity. That's what you call as hybrid. Then, mutual funds. Mutual fund. Is a fund pooled among the members
security holders in India. This is a public offering. Anyone can join that fund. And the body which is managing these funds, we call it as asset managing company or AMC. And it is organized as a combination with AMC, sponsor, trustee, unit holder, and custodian. All put together becomes a mutual fund. Each fund will tell you where it is the money going. Whether they are putting your money in debt instruments, equity instruments, money market instruments, or combination of few of this or all of this. They will tell you. Based on that, you can. Now, my point of discussion here is, these are tradable this way. Actually, you can see here. First, here you have mutual funds, and here also you have mutual funds. In both the places you have mutual funds. The reason here is, you have tradable mutual fund schemes for units, and mutual funds where the liquidity is given by the AMC itself. As a reason, they fall both places. The tradable mutual funds are those funds which are closed. Closed in means like IPO, this is more into the capital markets module. One, an AMC invites money from the public to start a new fund. We call it as NFO. New fund offer. Okay. In the case of closed-ended funds, what happens is, whatever the money it collects, it could be 1 crore, 10 crore, 1000 crore, based on your response, I get the money. There's no limit on that. I collect the money, and once the last date gets over, I close it. It is closed. And the same money is used to invest in different industries by the portfolio managers. Or the asset management fund. Okay? There's something interesting you can find in the best portfolio managers in India. Quite interesting. How much they have given in the past 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, and so on. You don't go in the company. Right? You are deceived. If you are going in the company, you are deceived. You should go with each scheme's fund manager. One AMC will have tens or hundreds of schemes, whichever schemes. All that means some of them are closed-ended, some of them are open-ended. Okay? So closed-ended means there are two types again. One, they invest in securities. The other one, they call it as ETF. Exchange Traded Funds. Are showing in the business slide. There was a good narration. Now people are looking more for ETFs. Right? So both are closed-ended. Then if the fund is closed, then who will give me money if I want money? You have to sell in the market. Closed-ended mutual funds are listed in BSE and NSE. Okay. Then open-ended mutual funds, NFO comes, last date, whatever, even after that you want to invest, yes, you can invest. You can. That's the difference between closed-ended and open-ended. And after investing, if you want money, you have to approach the AMC. There is no market for that. You have to go to the mutual fund company, that is AMC, and fill the form and demand your money. You will get back to that. That happens with open-ended. So that is how I put mutual funds here which are non-tradable. Non-tradable means liquidity is there with the issuer. Tradable means in the market. Got it? Makes some sense? Interesting? Tradable mutual fund units which are closed. Okay? Now these things are known to you all. Non-tradable. Related to all these three instruments or categories of instruments, the liquidity lies with the issuer. There is no market for them. There is no tradability. There is no transferability. That's all. Them here, this kind. Right? You have deposits issued by a
commercial banks, corporations, financial institutions, they are issuing the deposits. Don't get confused. Corporate issue bonds, debentures, they are also issuing deposits. Deposits are not transferable. So, there is no market for them. So, you cannot trade. Okay? So, deposits happen that way. It should be a commercial bank, financial institutions, and corporations. Then you have loans taken by individuals, companies, in government. They take loans, someone gives loan. A person or the body or the company which gives loan, it is acceptable. Whoever takes loan is liability. Again, these loans could be of two types, basically domestic and foreign. Foreign loans taken in Indian corporate world is called as external commercial borrowers. This is the motivation. Why like that? Interest rates are high here. In US, they are very cheap. Hardly 2% or 1.5%. Better be good. Okay? That is the idea where we shift from one financial system to other financial system, or one country to another country, because of differences in interest rates. Okay? So, loans happen that way. Then, other instruments like there is some board called loans. Treasury notes important. Treasury bills, you know. Treasury bills. This is, you know, come back to that. Treasury bills, have you heard? I think not security for some reason. Bonds issued by government. Okay? So there is something called notes issued by government, which are for bonds are typically even longer terms, 20 years, 30 years, and so on. But notes are for a short term compared to that, say for 10 years, 5 years, 4 years. Where if they are similar to deposits by banks and other companies, there is no transferability. Government has to issue the term of the year. That's the reason we call them as notes. Then this acceptance, this happens more with the exports. I'm supposed to receive, I'm supposed to give. So a bank will give you the issuance. When bankers' acceptance is there, based on that, you can take a loan also. That is like a foreign trade or export. Okay? Then mutual funds open-ended, I already told you. Then chip fund is something unique in India. It is born in India. Unfortunately, we don't know where our products happens. In Africa, in South American countries, Latin American countries, it's called as ROSCA. Okay? Rotating Savings Credit Associations, ROSCA. In India, it's chip fund. That is very strong, beautiful instrument. Why I'm saying beautiful in this? It is flexible, it is good, it is transparent, it is for everyone. But unfortunately, unorganized chip funds are more, which have created a lot of problems in giving bad leverage to members. Organized chip funds are so good. It's like mutual fund we discussed. Funds are pulled up among us only. Okay? Say, for example, 50 students are there, 50 members will be there, including me. As I'm a little experienced, I will be the organizing member of this, where it is known as the term is used as foreman. I'm the foreman for this fund, but I should be a member. I'm among 50 members. So what happens? Every month we collect 1,000 rupees. How much is celebrated in a month? 50,000. So 50,000 is available. We take a lottery. Take a lucky day, 50 members will be there, we take the day, and for 50 months, 50 names will come. First month, X, second month, Y, something like that. So we collect 50,000 every month, and whoever is in the first month, we give it to him or give it to them. Second month, whatever will be the name,
get it?
Yes, sir.
Then what's the problem here? Is there a problem?
Yes, sir.
What is the problem?
People who come in the last.
She's very practical. Anything else? What's the problem here? Yeah, the first person will be very happy. Received 50,000, which has to be paid 1,000 rupees each for 50 months. No interest. Happy. That's what you said, right?
Yes.
Very happy. The poor guy
who is getting the last.
Last one. In 50th month, pay 1,000 rupees every year for 50 months. So that's the problem. So what I do is, so he started fighting. So what is this? You gave to him, I want the money. I want to start a small business, maybe. Right? It's a good platform. Then what I will do? Tell, raise hands whoever wants money in this first one. Then I will bring you both. You tell me how much you want to lose right now. You will be getting 50,000 now. So how much you want to lose? She will say, sir, I will lose 100 rupees. He will say 200. She will say 300. Like that, bidding goes on and on. And suddenly from that corner, that guy says, sir, 1,000 rupees. Right? So, what is the need for money in that one for a person? What is the needed amount? That's how cheap it is. That's how cheap for it is. This is the oldest form of economic distribution which was there. This is the oldest form of money in India. Livestock, business, even commodities. People used to have pull up rice bags. One from everyone every month, like that they used to do. If you're interested more, I can tell you more. Finally, risk management tools. We have insurance and derivatives. Insurance, we have life insurance, ULIP, general insurance. Derivative is not a trading or investment tool, it is basically a risk management tool to protect the risk. We have features, powers, and options. Right? Then, foreign currency exchange is also a financial instrument. Finally, cryptocurrency, first of all, these types of financial instrument is a big question mark. Till today, SEC, Securities Exchange Commission, because it is allowed in the US, it considers it as a commodity, not a financial instrument. That's a different regulator in the US. There are a lot of questions, we'll have conversation on that. Okay? So, this is our discussion on financial instruments today. Any quick questions to take on anything on the board? Yeah, Adresh, your face looks like lots of questions. But again, the answer is very simple. I will not ask you. No, at least not today. Any other question? Have you find it out?
Yeah.
Thank you all. If you have any questions, you can bring me back to the next session also. Okay? Remember whatever I said. Go through the business plan today and in order to business plan. Thank you all.
Thank you.